So class 10, today we are going to revise this chapter from the diary of Anne Frank. So the main highlights of the chapter we have already discussed, and now I think that we will discuss about some of the MCQs. Okay. So for the MCQs, let me speak. First of all, let me make these two students enter the class. Yes. Now here, as you know that this paragraph is written, you can see on your screens, it is displayed that paper has more patience than people. I thought of this saying on one of these when I was feeling a little depressed. One minute, please. Depressed and was sitting at home with my chin in my hands, bored and listless. Wondering where to stay it in or go out. I finally stayed where I was. One minute, please. I finally stayed where I was brooding. Yes, paper does have more patience since I'm not planning to let anyone else read this stiff bag notebook. Grandly referred to as diary, unless I should ever find a real friend, it probably won't make a bit of difference. Now, the first question is, paper has more patience than people. So this we know that she has said, she said so. She said so, it is because of the reason, because people are judgmental in nature. They pass on their judgments. They are also critical in their nature. And moreover, they are all not rational in their approach. So they pass on their judgments to the lives of the other people. So this is the reason she said that she can pour out her feelings completely onto the paper, and paper will never speak in return. It will not pass any kinds of comments. So this is the reason why she said so. So the first question is, paper has more patience than people. What does this imply? What it means? The options are, believed in the power of writing more than speaking to people, or felt that she could pour her heart out on paper without any hindrance, or had more faith in sharing her thoughts and feelings with paper, or felt that she could share her feelings openly on paper. Yes. So what can be the correct option? See, just tell me, raise up your hands, which option is the most appropriate one? Yes. I'm repeating the options. It is believed in the power of writing more than speaking to people. What do you think, that this option is correct? Yes, Bhumika, let yourself unmuted only. Yes, Raghav Arora, Anshika, unmute yourselves also in order to participate in discussion. Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Bhumika.
Ma'am, I think.
I have unmuted you. Just unmute yourself, please. Yes. So some problem is there. Let me explain side by side. So now, it is students are still entering the class. Yes. So, believed in the power of writing more than speaking to people. No. This can't be the right option. Okay. Because she has not mentioned in the chapter about the power of speaking. Or she felt she could pour her heart out on paper without any hindrance. Yes, we can consider it. Okay, because when she said that saying on one of those days when I was feeling a little depressed and sitting at home with my chin in my hands, bored and listless, wondering whether to stay, finally stayed in and brooding. Yes, paper does have more patience than people. Okay, it means that a person can pour his heart out onto paper without any interruption. Next is, had more faith in sharing her thoughts and feelings with paper. No. she, because what this option is saying, it is contradicting to this paragraph, because in this paragraph, what she said that she doesn't say that there are not many people in her life. She said, I had number of friends, but see this last line, but I don't have anyone, you can say, to whom I should confide in. Okay, I can call friends. I have a family, loving ones, like, so this is wrong option. Next is, feel that she could share her feelings openly on paper. No, she never wanted, because writing a diary means writing in secret. And in the first, you can say, stanza, she has very much mentioned that no one would be ever interested in the musings of this 13-year-old girl. Means if anyone would get a chance. So what is the right option is, it is had more faith in sharing her thoughts and feelings with paper without any hindrance is the right answer to this question. Right? So the next question is, what does patience mean? What is synonym of patience? It is indolence, grit, perseverance, or tolerance? Yes. What can be the correct answer to this is? Any guesses from your side? Grit and perseverance, known, and it is not at all tolerance. It is only indolence, right? So the next question is, if the diary, just a moment, please. If the diary were a real friend, what qualities would Anne expect it to have? What she wanted? What does she want it? Just note down in your rough notebooks and tell me which options she actually wanted. Optimistic, she wanted it. Good listener, she wanted it. Confident, energetic, non-judgmental, outgoing, or ambitious? What does she want? Optimistic she want, Bhumika? No, she doesn't want, right? She wanted it to be a good listener? Yes. Okay, it means second option is also correct. Then confident. Yes, here confident, it is not D-E-N-T confident, it is C-O-N-F-I-D-E-N-T confident. Means confident means to whom you can freely express your feelings and without any, you can say, fear that this person will disclose my feelings. Okay, its meaning is this. So this is also the right option. It means second, third, and energetic, no. And it must be non-judgmental, yes. Because this is the reason why she said that paper has more patience, because people are judgmental in nature. So the option 2, 3, and 5, which I have spoken, is the correct answer. Next question is, pick out the sentences that brings out the meaning of brooding. You know here, brooding is used here. Okay, I'm pointing my cursor here, brooding. And what it means? Okay, what it means, it is, first is, it is the mysterious house on the hill is still brooding above the village. Which sentence expresses its meaning? Okay. Second option is, the people of the stock market always keep brooding about the gains. Means they are thinking about the gains. This is the right. Okay, next is, he was brooding over the matter and took a long time to decide. And next one is, suspense and drama were brooding at the site of the investigation. So what do you think is the correct option? Any guesses from your side? Yes. Anything? See, the first option, that is the first option, is the mysterious house on the hill is still brooding. Its wrong use of brooding is to have a deep thinking. Okay, lost in your own thoughts. Above the village, it is not right option. People at the stock market always keep brooding about the gains. No. No. This is not, you can say, brooding is not about, you can say, some output of the gains. Next is, he was brooding over the matter and took a long time to decide. Yes, this is the right option here, that he took a long time and to brood and finally to decide. So this is the right option to be used here. Okay. So next, afterwards, next question is, Anne doesn't plan to let anyone else read her diary. As why she never wanted anyone to read her diary? Why she did not want? She is, but let me speak the options. The options are, she is secretive about life. It's about her intimate feelings. She is willing to share it with anyone, or she wants to cherish these moments herself. Why she is writing a diary? Why Anne doesn't plan to let anyone else read her diary? So how you will find out the options for it? So the first one is, she is secretive about her life. No, she never wanted her life to be secretive. No, it's about her intimate feelings. Yes, which she never wanted to discuss with others. She wanted to explain it here in this manner. Or she is unwilling to share. If she is not unwilling to share it with anybody, why she has said in the starting of this paragraph, which is displayed as para one on the screen, that if anyone would find my diary. Okay, so she is not so willing. And she wants to cherish. No. So the right option is, she. It's about her intimate feelings. Okay. So now, next, I am going to display you another paragraph about Mr. Keating. Yes, here it is. Mr. Keating had a good laugh. Okay, so this is the paragraph displayed here. Mr. Keating had a good laugh at my arguments, but when I proceeded to talk my way through the next lesson, he assigned me a second essay. This time I was supposed to be on it was supposed to be on an incorrigible chatterbox. I handed it in and Mr. Keating had nothing to complain about. For whole lessons, however, during the third lesson, it's finally had enough. Anne Frank, as a punishment for talking in the class, write an essay entitled Quack, 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 said Mistress Chatterbox. So now this is the passage in front of you. And on the basis of it, I'm going to ask you some questions. The question is, what convincing argument was made by Anne? What convincing means how she tried to convince Mr. Keating. The options are, she was talkative, just like any other student in the class. She said so. This next option is, she had the right to be talkative as it was a classroom and not a prison. Or she had inherited the trait from her mother, so she couldn't stop being talkative. Or last is, she found it impossible to be quite like the other as she couldn't change herself. So raise up your hands for the answer, as this has already been discussed a number of times. Yes, Bhumika. Where are you, Bhumika? Let me check out. 1 minute, please. Yes. Unmute yourself. Yes, Bhumika. You can unmute yourself. I have unmuted you. Anshika, you can.
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, she has inherited it from her mother.
Very good. So what it means? It means that she has inherited the trait from her mother. So this we have read a number of times in the chapter. Okay. So please don't mute yourself. So the next question is, what does had a good laugh imply in the context to Mr. Keesing? What does good laugh? What it means? It means that he celebrated his ability to make and write the essay, or he ridiculed Anne in front of the whole class, or pulled up Anne for her arguments in her essay, or realized the humor in it and was amused. Question is, what does had a good laugh means to Mr. Keesing? Yes, of course. Yes, Anshika. Don't please mute yourself again and again. It's difficult to unmute you again and again. Yes, Anshika.
Ma'am, last option.
Ma'am, D option.
It's right. It's D option, that he realized the humor, okay, and in it and was amused. So right answer it was. So the next question is, based on this extract, pick out the option with the list of words that best describe Mr. Keesing. So what are the qualities of Mr. Keesing? You have to tell me what are the qualities of Mr. Keesing. He was jovial and creative. Jovial means of funny nature, always making fun. Next is strict and innovative, tolerant and strict, or innovative and jovial. So what do you think? What are the traits of his personality? He was jovial and creative. He was strict and innovative. He was tolerant and strict, or he was innovative and jovial. Yes. What do you think is the right option? Yes, participants. Yes, Anshika, you can speak out. You are still unmuted. Yes, please. Yes, Bhumika, you can speak out.
He was funny.
No, he was.
Ma'am, strict and innovative.
Very good. It is strict and innovative. Very good, Bhavna, that it is strict and innovative. Why it is strict and innovative? Because jovial, he was not always in funny mood. Okay, he was not of jovial nature. If he would have been of jovial nature, why he would have given punishment to Anne? Creative to some extent, okay, but creative is not the right one. It means he is finding out innovative ways to make the child right on the track. So this is strict and innovative. So why he was strict? Because he never tolerated unfriendly talking in the class. So the next one is, why do you think Mr. Keesing chose the title An Incorrigible Chatterbox for Anne to write on? Why he has chosen this An Incorrigible Chatterbox? Because he expected that Anne to express her inability to elaborate on such a topic, or that this would embarrass Anne and would check her indiscipline, or her to apologize and not repeat her talkative behavior, or Anne to explore her creative writing skills? What is the best option here? Yes. Why he has given? So the first option, let us analyze. First option is Anne to express her inability to elaborate on such a no. He has never thought this. And the next option is to apologize and not to repeat her talkative behavior. Okay. And one option is that this would embarrass Anne and would check her indiscipline. This is the right option here to be given. Okay. So it means that he wanted that she should check her indiscipline and should improve herself. Next question to this context is, to this paragraph is, how did Anne feel when she was punished the third time by Mr. Keesing? How she felt when she was punished the third time? She was happy, as she had to write 3 essays on her the same topic. Second option is enjoyed making fun of Mr. Keating in her own way. Third option is was worried as she had run out of original ideas for her essay, or she was thrilled at another opportunity to showcase her writing abilities. So some tricky questions are there. Yes. So what do you think? So here the right option is she was worried as she had run out of her original ideas. Okay, she was not able to find out her original ideas, and why that she had run out of original ideas that she has written about an incorrigible chatterbox 2 times. Okay, so this is the reason why she was feeling tired of that writing the essay again and again, right? So students, in this manner you will get various, you can say, questions, right? So let me have a short quiz from the chapter also. These were some questions that are supposed to be of that time in case of CBSE exam. Now let us have a short quiz about the important facts of the chapter. So when was Anne born? On June 29th? June 1931 or June 1932? Immediately raise up your hands if you know the answer so that I can get the answers. Yes, Bhumika, Anshika, whatever, Bhavna, unmute yourselves immediately to give the answers. Yes, she was born in 1929. Not much time to be taken. What do most people do in her diary? Okay, so what they write in diary according to first paragraph? So about their hobbies? No. Write facts? Yes. Write their happiest moment? No, or none of the above. So it means they write the facts there. So who was Anne's two friends? Her pen Kitty, her cat Kitty, her diary Kitty. It was not none other than
her diary
Kitty. Okay, her diary Kitty. How old was Anne's father when he married her mother?
34, 35, 36, 32? 36.
I clearly mentioned her mother was 25 at that time. What was the name of Anne Frank's sister? Margaret, Margot, Mary, Marina. It was Margot. What was Anne Frank's full name? What was her full name? It was Annalise Mary Frank, Anna Marion Frank, Anne Mark Frank, or Annalise Mariana Martina Frank. It is Annalise Mary Frank. This is the complete name of Anne Frank. Okay. The next question is, why did she not want to give a brief in the diary at first? She didn't want to be formal. She wanted the diary to be her real friend, or she did not like the idea, or both one and two.
Ma'am, please repeat the question.
Question is, why did she not want to give a brief in the diary at first? She decided that she should not give any brief account of herself. Why she decided it earlier? She didn't want it to be formal. She wanted the diary to be her real friend, or she did not like the idea. It is both one and two, that she didn't want to be formal and she wanted the diary to be her real friend. Okay. Okay. When was, this is just a simple one. You can answer it in very easy way. When was the diary given to Anne? On her 11th birthday, 12th birthday, 13th birthday, or 14th birthday?
On her 13th birthday.
13th birthday.
Okay. Why does Anne think she was lonely? Why she always thinks she was lonely? She had no friends, she had no real friends, or she was all alone, or she was an introvert?
She has no real friend.
Very good. She has no real friends. So how she justified her being talkative in her essay? She discussed the subject topics in class, or it is a habit, what she said, or it is an inherited trait from her mother and you can't do much about it, the class is boring.
It is inherited.
Okay. Which subject was she not sure of passing? Math, science, English, all of them? Which subject she thought she would not do much better? It was in mathematics. Why writing in diary? Last question is, why was writing in a diary a strange experience for Anne? Why it was a strange experience for Anne? The options are, first is, she had never written anything before. She didn't know how to write. Neither she nor anyone else would be interested in it later. Or it is both A and C option.
Both A and C.
Very good. It is both A and C.
C.
Okay, very good. Okay, now last question. I think you will be able to find it out. Let me see. Why does she give a brief sketch about her family in the diary? Why she has given a brief sketch? No one would understand if she drove right in to introduce Kitty to her family. She would forget facts about her family, or she liked talking about her family.
First option.
Very good. This is the first option. And I think so that with this, the revision is done for this chapter, and next afterwards in the next class we will have the MCQs based upon 100 dresses 1 and 2. Okay, so that's all for today's class. Okay, now if you have your doubts you can ask me, and in the extra class I will also carry forward the 100 I will also